present to you. One of the best informative and website that connect the African continent to the Scandinavian countries. The name of the website is called Scandic Africa. What does the Scandic Africa do? Scandic Africa promotes the interrelationship between the Scandinavian countries and the African continent. How do we do that? We promote business, we go to seminars that relate to African countries. We cover the events and try to relate whatever that is in the conference to the people. And then we have a very deep contact with most organizations, the African people in Scandinavian countries. These organizations vary from the organization varies from we showed it, It is just a kind of a platform that you can go into all the time to read about, oh, how did they behave? How did they do their traditional weddings in this part of the country? This is a wedding between the Ghanaians and the Nigerians. And they did it in Gothenburg. We also go as far as trying to celebrate individuals, countries, nations, tribes that are doing traditional weddings. Like a country, like a little kid that doesn't know how to do that traditional way, I'll be one. If you decide to learn how to know that, you can go into the website, you see how the little kid posts in there, you'll be able to know how they dress, you'll be able to read about what the organization is all about, you'll be able to know their way of life, their feeding, and their food. Also, these are some of the other people that are much more interested in the cultural heritage of the African people that we took the pictures. We also cover some other countries like the Eritreans, because Africa has a unique genders, unique tribe, unique, different cultures. We go around with all these people. We have a direct contact with most of all these organizations. They always call us. We are always there to cover the events, to talk to them, to see their movement, to pass the message across to the others, so that when they see, if they don't even want to be there at the initial stage, the moment they know we are going to be there, they want to be part of that organization, they want to be part of the movement, they want to be seen, they want to be celebrated, and that is what we are out for. Part of what we do, this is a very special dress from Eritrea. The first one by the left is called Tigrayan, and they have about 9 different tribes in Eritrea. We cover that here in Sweden. And we also have the Bondo dress, which is from Sierra Leone, standing Catholic leaders. And those are some of the people that are having fun on that. Then not only that, in terms of music, we have the African Marketplace. We are already in partnership with them to see how some of the cultural aspects of the music of the African things are going to be displayed in the streets of Sweden. And the last one we did was in Avenue. The first one was done in Florida Torre. And this kind of work is going to move around Sweden. So those are some of the things that Scandic Africa does. We promote also the Scandinavian interest. We travel as much as I was in with one of my team. We were in Uganda last year, and we went exactly to Kampala, the business district. There was a company called Oriflame. Oriflame is a Swedish company. We talked to the people around those vicinities, what they feel about Oriflame, what they think about their product. And they will try as much as possible to ask them if they should compare Swedish products with some other country products. What are your feelings? And some of the things that we hear from them, we put it on the webpage. And they will be planning in future, probably before the end of the year, to visit 3 African countries, Nigeria, Ghana, and Cameroon, to try and promote the Scandinavian interest as well as promote the African interest. Because we think it's going to be a way thing, both left and right. When the African are making a little bit improvement, the Scandinavia as well, because the African needs the Scandinavia for the development as much as the Scandinavia has to see Africa on the other way. And that is where the Scandic Africa comes in, to come as a kind of a bridge, to bring in a kind of a balance in our own set of information. Plus, what other things we do, we also celebrate individuals that are kind of an inspiration source to other Africans. We do it in such a way that people that are just in the town, they don't know what to do. They think the best thing for them to do, having been here, and the thing is too hard for them to just have a headway in life. We try as much as possible to interview individuals that started from nothing, and they make a headway. That is the fact that we did interview him through Skype. And that was some few months back and in the beginning of this year, and he gave us an interview. For the one that you are very much familiar with, this is Salon Safari. This woman is based here in Gothenburg. She has a shop in the center of Gothenburg. Virtually everyone that has anything to do with braid knows her. She started from nothing. She has a shop here in Gothenburg. She has in Stockholm. And the last time we spoke to her, she said she's trying to start a kind of franchising. These are some of the inspiration that most African people, whosoever that want to get to know the source, their stories, needs to know about them. These are the people they have to see as a kind of a motivation, as a kind of people that you have to see. Just for you to get this kind of dream, if these people can do it, I myself, I can try something. I can do it, and I'll have a headway. Those are some of the things that the Scandic Africa stand for. Also, what have we achieved so far? In our website, if our website. It is one of the basic websites that you are going to see that when we go out, we try as much as possible to ask you what you're wearing. If you have a unique dress that has to pertain to some certain tribe, we ask you what you're wearing. Where does it come from? And the purpose of doing that is to tell people to pass the message across. If you don't know about those people, if you've not heard anything about them, to try to get interest to know about it, to learn about it. But what we have already, we will try to interview them, we will take a picture about it, then we will write a little bit about the culture. So you would learn about it if you want to travel to Africa. If you are interested in business, it's the same thing. For you to do a business in Africa, you have to understand the people. And that is just a basic opportunity for you to learn about it. So also we encourage other nationals to come together to celebrate their identities and their cultural value for others to learn about it. It was when we started this thing that Sierra Leonean, after we covered their event, they eventually came together to form an organization, which they said they are going to do bigger next year. So with that, we as a Hispanic African, what are the future plans we have? Coming 1st of July, we're going to have an online magazine in which all what we have covered within the month is going to be compacted together on that online magazine. So you can read through and check whichever one that you are much more interested to you, from business to culture to music or to people's and events that you want to see. And also we intend to extend our coverage because we have covered an event in Norway and then we're going back there because we have an invitation. We're trying to go the same way to Stockholm with this Miss African Beauty Contest and we are extremely very strong game there. So we intend to extend our coverage to other Scandinavian countries so that they will get to know more about us. And coupled with that, we intend to travel to Africa, which is going to be before the end of the year, to 3 countries, to just ask people what they feel about the Scandinavian countries, what they feel about their products, and try to change a kind of a notion, because one of the basic tools that we think that the Americans are using are just dispensation of information. That is what people in Africa know, and it's the same thing that they know about the UK. But the little way we can do, we will try the best we can. And that is what we are. We are just the bridge between the African and the Scandinavian country. Thank you very much for listening to me.
Countries and the African continent can benefit together. and what we promote this young lady around the world as in African countries.
Yeah.
With a lot of different tracks, for example. How many are there? 20?
30? No, we're four. This is it.
Four.
We're four. This is it. Basically, the idea is this. Scandinavia, Africa, the bridge, Scandic Africa. Business that has anything to do with Africa, we're there to cover the event, to rally around people to come to that seminar. When it comes to music, people that are interested in music to come to the event, they get in touch with us, we try as much as possible to invite many people to come there. When it comes to culture, we do the same thing. We call all of that people, are you interested in this thing? So nation, I do this thing. We rally around them. Then we're going to the event. Just the bridge. When it comes to this Scandinavian country and African continent, that is where we stand. That is Scandic Africa.
I think if you focus on one issue, develop that into excellence, and then continue to the next thing.
That's good.
Another question I thought about is, Africa is a continent.
Yeah.
It's a different markets, different countries, different cultures.
Yeah.
If I were a Swedish company interested in Africa, I would focus specifically on one market, one target country, and go to that one. It's like saying if you were an African country, go to Europe.
Yeah.
What you can sell in Italy, you can't sell in Sweden. You have to separate the markets.
I just want to probably explain it a little bit. There was one conference we went for in Norway, Trondheim. It's called a Business Focus on East Africa. There were about five African countries that were there. And the basic idea of that conference was just to look for interested entrepreneurs that wanted to invest in Africa. And where we came in on that particular thing was just to cover the event and try to let people that doesn't know about the particular seminar to know about it. Our own is more information dispensation, not the business aspect of it, but like a kind of a mini media to project and to promote these two continents in a little way we can. So not in terms of real business, wanting to do business with different countries, but being able to capture all the countries within the continent and the Scandinavian countries, and being able to project it and pass the information across to the people.
How will you get paid? What fees?
So far so good, we charge on hourly basis for what we do. On hourly basis, we will send our bills to you and we will talk about the bills on hourly basis if we have to be there. So that's what we do. But when it comes to small organizations, we try as much as possible to encourage them and give them free service sometimes.
Okay, that's fine. We need to take, will you make a presentation?
Yeah.
And you have your own computer. Because that's like they have one the same computer first to link to this connection. We take off for that.
But it's okay.
Often.